morning, okay? The following day, he called in the evening. Where are you? I said, this way am I. He said, he's coming to see me. That he was the one that called me. He's not calling with the normal number here. And he was the one that called me yesterday. When he eventually came to the church we met, he said, yes, that he was coming from the Republic that yesterday. I said, okay, that's still abroad anyway. Amen. And what is the problem? Somewhere in Mina, they call the place Lambata. He bought a shop with his money. He didn't know he was buying debt. Why? Somebody has planted something in the shop. He put his brother there while his tears are burning. The boy began to die. Sickness, sickness, sickness. One day, the chemist person where he used to go and buy medicine called him and said, look, this thing happening to you is exactly what happened to the person that stayed in that shop before you came. And he has been carried home already before your brother bought it. I advise you to do something or leave that place. He called us and this is the problem. He said, okay, there's no problem. Just as my brother said, the kingdom of God is about power. And power passes power. We went. I eventually went together. We went and anointed the shop. And by the grace of God, the problem has gone. He's still there doing his business. Who did it? An enemy of progress. Many of us do so many things just to make sure we pass every other person in our line. We make sure we tie them. We make sure we strangle their business. We make sure we tie their destiny. Why? So that we become the number one. After being number one, don't you know there is a father, a source, you will go back to give account. Tell somebody there is a day of accountability. That's why today we are looking at thy kingdom come. Many of us are eating the forbidden fruit in one way or the other. The word of God says flee from fornication. It didn't say fight it, it said flee, run from it. Many of us are even sleeping with our sales girls. And we call it nothing. And we want the kingdom of God to come. If we want the kingdom of God to come, we must be willing to do away, to stop eating the forbidden fruit. Because that's what brought darkness into the world. That's what brought man into this mess. That's why there's pain, there's weakness, there's sickness, there's stagnation, there's frustration, there are barriers and barricades facing us in one way or the other. There's non-achievement, there's insufficiency. Many of us are just trading, but are just living from hand to mouth. We live in a zone called insufficiency. Why? Because man lost the kingdom. It was not so from ab initio, from the beginning. God is a God of love, and he had good plans for you and I. We must return to the kingdom. Tell somebody by your side, we must return to the kingdom.
We must return to the kingdom.
Amen.
Amen.
The word of God says, follow peace with all men, and that holiness without which we can see the Lord. Are you a peacemaker? Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called the children of God. Follow peace with all men. Are you known for peace in your line? Are you known for peace in this marketplace? Or are you a troublemaker? Many of us sponsor riots. Do you know that sometimes market fire is being caused by on purpose by some individuals? Market fire that will keep many people stranded. Many people settle their apprentice, but they settle them with evil money. So the boy will never be more than you. And you are here in this market. And that's what we have come to say. Whatever is not of God in this market must be paralyzed. Holy Ghost!
Fire!
Holy Ghost!
Fire!
Holy Ghost!
Fire!
After this program, whatever they do will backfire by fire. Backfire by fire. Backfire by fire. Jesus. I talked to a man about coming into the kingdom. He refused. He was a driver, driving this narrow one stuff. He believed so much in that kingdom. Made charms. Some are even talking charms. So that he will do what? Disappear in case of any accident. The day he died, it was in that same vehicle that killed him. Somebody I spoke to, not that I had it. The motor went into an accident. He decided decided to disappear, and the vehicle decided to disappear the area he was disappearing. And before he could vanish, the vehicle has already fallen on him. And nothing happened with his conductor. Both they were staying together. After today, whoever is relying on any charm to do any incantation, to do any witchcraft, to do any evil, it will backfire on their head. 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 In the name of Jesus. Because when the kingdom of God is enthroned, every other kingdom will not stand. Every other kingdom will not stand. All we are trying to say is, oh God, thy kingdom come. Matthew chapter 6, verse 33. He says, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Every other thing shall be added. There are many of us here in this market. Even though you know about this crusade, you feel too busy to come. Why? Because you are looking for other things. I don't blame you. Maybe you read science. There was a man called Maslow who was not a Christian, and he taught us the basic necessities of life. And he said the basic needs of life are food, clothing, shelter, and so on and so forth. But that is not true. We all believe the God didn't know the truth. Perhaps you are Maslow's brothers. That all a man needs is food, shelter, clothing. Those are material things. But when Jesus came, he corrected Maslow. He said, Maslow, you are wrong. He said, the priority of life should be set on two things: the kingdom of God and the corresponding righteousness. Righteousness simply means being in alignment with the kingdom of God. Righteousness is about the position you occupy in the kingdom of God, the position that manifests at this position. So to receive that location in the location, somebody sound fire. So Jesus said, no, Master, you are wrong. He said, seek first the kingdom of God. There are many of us who are too busy for God. That's why there's a story in the Gospel according to Luke chapter 16, the story of the rich fool. The Bible said this man got everything. He never knew. He thought the source of his wealth was outside the kingdom. Many of us don't know that we are blessed for the kingdom. We are blessed by the kingdom for the kingdom and supposed to be a Kingdomite. That is called Kingdomocracy. Yes, Kingdomocracy. Blessing. Blessing from the kingdom. For the kingdom. By the Kingdomites. That is why we say that a kingdom come. He got everything. He thought it was by his own strength. He would think that you will make it because you come to market early and you close late. You think that that's why you make it. No. Life does not answer to sorrow. The Bible said the race is not to the swift. Neither the battle to the mighty. It's of God that showeth mercy. If God says yes, nobody can say no. If God says no, nobody can say yes. If God opens your door, nobody can close it. When God blesses you, nobody can curse you. When God curses you, nobody can bless you. When God says it is well, it will be well, even in the well. That's all we are saying. Thy kingdom come. And this and that. I will pull down my bars and I will begin to expand it. Much more than enough. Many of us already planning for next year. Planning is good, but planning outside God, you can plan, but only God can add a T to the plan to make it a plant. Not everybody who plants, plants. Until God adds a T to your plan, you can't plant the plan.
Oh, yes.
That same mind, God said, thou should. Your soul is meted tonight. And the Bible said, those things, to whom now shall they go? Excuse me, steward, am I permitted to cross? This is, if God calls you tonight, are you ready? No. Are you already in the kingdom? Are you going to say, excuse me, give me more time, let me prepare. Give me more time, let me go and pray. Give me more time, let me go and call the prayer coordinator. Give me more time, let me attend to church. Give me more time, let me go to settle accounts. Let me go and know to make amends. No, are you ready? Whether it calls you by 6 or at 4, in the noon or in the night, in the market or in the hospital, wherever it calls you, the issue is, when you already make up your mind, when you are prepared, when you are preset, when you are preserved, when you are organized, when you are fire-eyed for the kingdom, there shall be no retreat, no surrender. You need not be afraid, neither by terror in the night, nor by the arrows in the day. The Lord will profession against you, prosper. Somebody shall fire. The Bible said that night,
And because he was not in the kingdom, that's what made him foolish. Excuse me. He was not a fool because he had wealth. Money is good. After the Bible says, it is God that gives power to create wealth. He was not foolish because he had influence. He was foolish because he did not think about his soul. He did not think about the kingdom. And the Bible said in Matthew 16:26, what shall it profit a man if he gains the whole world? If he has all the middle of the world, if he's called the Elijah, if he's called Baba, or God, Master, also, and all these things, if he gains all of the whole world and to suffer the loss of his soul, if you say you are mighty, if you say you are strong, the first place to exercise your mastery is over yourself. There are many people today who are called world champions. They have conquered in Olympics. They have conquered in World Cup. They have got many world medals. They have conquered every other person, but have not conquered themselves. They are still in slavery to their desires, to their appetites. They exhibit an outward mastery, but the greatest mastery is an inward mastery. Have you conquered your soul? Have you conquered your soul? Have you submitted your soul to the master? Have you submitted your soul to the maker? Or are you like that rich fool who conquered the world and got the best? Probably on the day of result, he was acknowledged, giving many accolades, and he was called number one, the best farmer of the year, the best musician of the year, the best businessman of the year, and so on and so forth. And while everybody was giving me thumbs up, heaven was giving me thumbs down.
Chechi chenduga bere wega kwa lobo gugaga ni magebe na nae ni najukwa le wege se mawa wo kone benga gawo chechi chenduga makana gugu gugu su. Are eating the forbidden fruits in one way or the other. But today you can make up your mind. You can say enough is enough. You can say, God, here I come. You can say, God, here I return. For the issue that God is always ready to welcome us. God is always ready to welcome us whenever we come. So it says, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. May your name be held holy. Do you hold the name of God holy in this market? I depend as well. We're light up plus lie. Everything is lie. We are swearing even though you know what you are saying is wrong. And you are still swearing in the name of Jesus. You are using to swear to confuse people so that you make it. Some people say there's no brother in the jungle. Excuse me, we are still in the kingdom. In the kingdom, we are brothers and sisters. And our life must be transparent. It calls for change. Change of heart. Change of attitude. Change of unction. What the Greek calls metanoia, metanoiete. Change of heart and afterthought. To say, I was going this way before. No, let me now begin to go this way. Metanoia. Change of attitude. Change of mindset. May all of us think that God only helps us when we do many other things outside the kingdom to help ourselves. But it's not true. It's not true. There's a blessing in the kingdom for the kingdomites. And that shall come your way in the name of Jesus.
Kingdom come. Why do we want the kingdom to come? Because man lost the kingdom. In Genesis chapter 3, we all know what happened. When man ate the forbidden fruit, man was not banished away from the kingdom. Man was removed from the embassy. Man became a fugitive. Man now became a minister without portfolio, an ambassador of no status and no country. Man was no longer qualified to represent the kingdom of heaven. And man now began to live it with his own muscle and strength and his own know-how and so on and so forth. And that's what many people are still doing today, thinking that we can do it and achieve success outside of the kingdom of God. The kingdom come means come back to the source. Tell somebody by your side, go back to the source. Everybody stand on your feet, stand on your feet. Say with me, today, I discover my source. I must go back to the source. In the name of Jesus. Now, have you ever seen a flower in the church before? Have you ever seen a flower in the church before? Is it
authentic or is it synthetic? It is synthetic and not authentic. Do you know what that means? It looks as if it is alive, but it's not alive. Number one, it looks fresh. Number two, looks beautiful. Number three, it may even be costly. But guess what? Has no life. If it must have life, then it must come with its source to the church. And that's what is called flower pot. Flower pot. Because the flower from ab initio, from creation, was created to come out from the earth. So it cannot survive outside the earth. So any day you unplug it from the earth, it will lose life. So they cannot fabricate something to represent it. So that you cannot put it in the church, it will still be beautiful, it will still be fresh, it will still be green. There are many of us who are looking fresh, who are looking beautiful, dignified, but in actual sense, there is no life.
Nothing.
That's why I said today in the book of Daniel, tekel, tekel.
O passé.
Mene, mene, tekel, o passé. We have been weighed and found to be too light. The kilo, the kilogram, the weight, the measure is looking for your weight, you couldn't see it. But you are there. Many of us are like that in the kingdom. You may be recognized in your church. You may be recognized in the market. You may have many names and titles. But does heaven recognize you? Why? As long as you are disconnected from Abba, disconnected from the source, disconnected from your father, you can't have recognition. Therefore, the greatest enemy of the tree, the greatest enemy of the flower, is not the one who brings a saw and cuts the tree from the stem. No. As long as the tree is connected to the source, if you cut it from the stem, it will still come back again. That's why the book of Micah said in Micah chapter 7 verse 8, he said, rejoice not over me, O my enemy, for even though I am down, I will still come up again. Even though I'm in darkness now, I will see I'm sure to come to light. God does that to me. Don't rejoice over me at this present moment. Even if I, as long as I'm in the kingdom, I may not have a shoe yet, I may not have a car yet, I may not be married yet, I may not have a house of my own, but as long as I'm in the kingdom, it's unnegotiable. I must make it. I must be blessed. I must be favored. I must be married. Amen. My car should be celebrated. Amen. My marriage must be celebrated. Amen. My children must be dedicated. Amen. It is our fire. Yeah. When we talk about thy kingdom come, it means a return to the kingdom. Every other thing that comes around it will become a blessing, an addition. When the sun comes upon the tree will utilize the sun and the presence of what is called photosynthesis. That means the combination of the two words, photo and synthesis, light and manufacturing or building. So you use the light of the sun to produce. Plus, somebody say plus.
Plus.
When the rain comes on the tree, the roots will absorb the root, the water, and it will be transported to sustain the tree. Why? Because the tree is still planted in its source. There are many enzymes we cannot see with our eyes in the soil. What do? They break up nutrients for the plant. Because the tree, as you see, eats food. They have to break up the plants, the nutrients, to sustain the life of the tree. Every other thing, even when the wind comes, wind is an agent of, propagation. Dispersal of seeds. Everything becomes a blessing. Why? Because the tree is planted on the earth, which is the source from the beginning. So the greatest enemy of the seed is the one that comes, the tree, is the one that comes and uproots it from the source. Uproots the flower from the source. The moment you uproot the seed, the tree, the flower from the source, every other thing that has been a blessing will reverse immediately and become a curse. Is a natural. The same sun that gives it photosynthesis energy will begin to scorch it, and the leaves will begin to dry up. The same sun. The same water soil that also transport nutrients will begin to make the thing to rot. The enzymes that used to break nutrients for it to begin to break the roots of the tree by itself. Everything becomes reversed. Maybe you are here under the sound of my voice, and it seems as if you have come to the bus stop of your life, and it seems as if everything is against you. Probably you have been disconnected. It's a time to return to your source. So that everything, and guess what? That same tree that is uprooted, it has a way of getting it to touch the soil again. Very soon, some roots begin to come out again. Anchor, it will stand again. Reconnection. If there's a disconnection, there can also be a reconnection. Help me preach this message to somebody by your side. If there was a disconnection, there can be a reconnection.
If there was a disconnection, there also be a reconnection.
See, bear fruits. They still carry fresh fruits. But that is temporary. Don't tell me, man of God is okay with me. That is temporary. Outside the kingdom is temporary. Your money is temporary. Your fame is temporary. Your wealth is temporary. Your influence is temporary. Everything outside the kingdom is temporary. Not permanent. Why? My hope is pure.
Nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sinless faith.
That's why I need to do it. Make haste. Make hay while the sun shines. Make haste and come to the kingdom that has permanent joy, permanent peace, permanent mercy, permanent grace, permanent anointing, permanent wisdom, permanent wealth, permanent health. That is the only kingdom where there is assurance. That's the only kingdom that one, a man, can stand and say no to death. That's only kingdom you have audacity to look death in the face and say, bah, I reject. Why? Kingdom authority. By tomorrow we look more into this. Maybe you are here. You are just standing, but there is no root. You have been disconnected. We're going to pray. For those who want to be reconnected. For those who want to be restored. Son, I will just round off with that. The prodigal son is just typical of you and I. It's written in the gospel according to Luke chapter 15. Jesus started, he said, there was a man who had 100 sheep, but he lost one. You may not know whether this crusade is being organized for the lost sheep, because he said he left in 99 and went in search of the lost sheep. Why was the sheep lost? Hey, the sheep was lost because it had mobility. The sheep was lost because of the grace God gave it. The sheep was lost because it can move. Had this been the sheep was lame, it couldn't have been lost. Excuse me? Are you lost because God has blessed you with wealth? Are you lost because God gave you good health? You don't know what it means to be in the hospital bed for 1 month, for 3 months? And that's why we have no time for God. When they talk about the kingdom of God, they say, we don't have time yet. And some say, well, after my apprenticeship, I'm still an apprentice. After my apprenticeship, I'm still too young. Let me enjoy my youth. Two sisters will approach. They say, we're still too young. Let's enjoy our youth. We will repent. We will change our life. But later, that was around 92 or 93, during Abiola riot. They were living in Zaria by then. Everyone was running. They entered Modu. They didn't reach the east. The two of them died in the accident that happened. Do you know whether this program is an opportunity for the lost sheep to be recovered? Why? The Bible says there's joy in heaven for one sinner that repents. Maybe because of your beauty. The blessing God gave you, that's what has not made you, took you out of the kingdom. You now begin to flirt, seduce men left, right, and center, or use your money. You are sleeping from one hotel to another. It's the blessing of God. Is it not what is causing you pain? Do you want to lose it? While Jesus was talking to the Jews, they thought he was talking about those who have left Judaism. And he said, guess what? Not just that a man lost a sheep. He said, there was also a woman. Tell someone by his side, there was also a woman. Because Jesus balances his message. What he has for the men, he also has for the women. When we talk to brothers, we also talk to sisters. So, instead of talking about those who have left, he said, the woman also have 10 coins. And he lost also one coin. Where was the one coin lost? In the house. Where was the sheep lost? Outside the house. So even though you may not have anything, what people call Bromo Ibramus, you may not have anything yet, you are not in the kingdom. You are the among those lost in the house. Nothing to glory about, nothing to make you do shakara, yet you are not in the kingdom. You are lost in the house. So the coin did not have left to move, yet it was lost in the house. The house could be our own family. The house could be our own denomination. Many of us are in the denomination. They are in the church, but they are out of touch by the master. It's not enough to be in the church. It's not everything that comes to church that is in the kingdom. After I go to the church with my shoe, doesn't mean that my shoe now is in the Kingdomite. No. It's not everything that goes to church that's in the kingdom. Adam was still in the paradise, in the kingdom, when God says, who are you? Can you answer that question? Where are you? Excellent. He was not talking about location. He was talking about dislocation. Amen. He was not trying to know Adam's location. No. He was trying to tell Adam that he has been dislocated.